Naval Air Station North Island in San Diego, California, is known as the birthplace of naval aviation. And for the last 16 years, the base has played host to the Coronado Speed Festival as a part of San Diego's Fleet Week. But for the first time this year, fans will witness landings on the runways like never before as Speed Energy Formula Off-Road joins the festivities. 16-year-old off-road phenom Sheldon Creed, IndyCar star EJ Viso, and the rest of the Formula Off-Road pilots are about to launch in California. Welcome to San Diego, California, and Speed Energy Formula Off-Road presented by Traxxas. I'm Brian Till, along with former IndyCar driver Robbie Buell. Taylor Snyder down in the pit lane. What a race we have on store for you here from San Diego. One of the neat things about the Formula Off-Road Championship, such a diversity in the racetrack, Robbie.
And it is absolute diversity. Think about where we were just last night at the SanSports Super Show. And now we're here at these active military runways, totally different surface. We're all concrete pavement, very abrasive versus metal jumps, dirt jumps, and tight, twisty stuff. Incredibly different.
I think as a driver, you've got to change your approach as to how you're going to get the weekend done. You still want to win, but a little different approach. You talk about the SanSports Super Show. Well, here we are in Costa Mesa, California, Orange County Fairgrounds. An echelon-style start, lined up side-by-side like motocross racers. BJ Baldwin, Baja 1000 winner, getting introduced to that short track racing that is Formula Off-Road.
And there's the diversity. Here are your dirt jumps along the front straightaway. Great for the fans. A little bit of bumping there with EJ Viso. We saw a lot of that, didn't we?
It wouldn't be the first time we saw EJ Viso getting a little aggressive throughout the night. Here he is beginning to put a move on Keegan Kincaid in the number 74. But in the end of race number one of two, Robbie Gordon, who takes the victory. Keegan Kincaid finishes second. Gordon with a little bicycle. For race number two, a sellout crowd witnesses more great SST Traxxas action. Down into turn one, and then it gets a little crazy. PJ Jones, Abdali Lopez.
Drives right over his hood, and look at this battle. EJ Viso just poking at Kincaid a little bit there. And there, that's the cutoff. PJ Baldwin taking the Joker.
Robbie Gordon was out front, but the Joker played havoc. Charles Dorrance, EJ Viso get together. No yield sign there, and then a mechanical issue, rare mechanical issue for Robbie Gordon while leading.
Little hiccup. Hiccup gives Kincaid the lead.
Once you give a guy like Keegan Kincaid the lead, he's going to hold on to it. That's exactly what he did. He won round number two. Two great races from just down the street in Costa Mesa, but we talk about how different this racetrack is, Robbie Buell. It's on a naval airport.
And that's one of the strengths of this series, is just the diversity of the tracks. Flat concrete, 90-degree corners, turn two, very quick corner. We have this long straightaway up to speeds of 130 miles an hour, have a tire chicane there at the end, some sweeping corners. Now we're gonna be setting ourselves up for some jumps, which is right where all the fans are. Want to talk about a fan-friendly racetrack? They can see everything that develops out on this active military airstrip.
And I would say that there's nothing for the drivers to hit except for the fact that there are a lot of trucks out there. They tend to rub on each other. Nick Vanis will start from the pole alongside Charles Dorrance. He didn't have the race that he wanted to have in Costa Mesa. We'll see what he can come away with here.
Row two, Scotty Steele ended up on the podium up the street last night along Lopez, who just keeps getting better and better.
Row three, EJ Viso, so aggressive over the last two races. And Bert Jenner had a fantastic run only to cut a tire down at Costa Mesa.
And here we got Sheldon Creed back, the guy who's chasing Robbie Gordon in this championship. Let's see what he can do alongside Keegan Kincaid, who drove for him the last two events of last night.
Dave Royce, Robbie Gordon in row five. Gordon, your championship leader as you go through the onboards. Dave Royce, a very good sports car driver. His first love really was off-road trucks, so he's right where he wants to be. Sheldon Creed in the 74. Keegan Kincaid filled in for him and won points for him over the last two rounds. Now Kincaid in his own truck getting his own points.
Yeah, so we'll see if these Traxxas teammates kind of work together or not.
Talked about Burt Jenner. Man, he's come a long way as a race car driver, not just a pretty face on the Kardashians. EJ Viso, the IndyCar star, adapting well to these trucks.
Abdali Lopez, he's having a great year with two wins at Indy and the X Games. And Scotty Steele finishing third on the podium at Sand Sports Super Show last night.
The guys are going to have the best shot here at the drop of the green. Charles Dorrance starts outside the front row, and Nick Vanis will start from the pole in his Icon Wraps SST Traxxas truck. Right now, fans filling the grandstands here, waiting for the flagman who's up on the wall to our screen right, waiting for the green flag. This is when you're sitting there nervous, the flag waves, and here we go, Robbie.
And hitting the ramps. And now remember, when they go down to turn one, these guys have not really had any practice time around here, and this track is wide open, and you're shooting for that cone that designates turn one.
Wide open to a hairpin, and that's one of the most challenging corners, especially when you've got a stack up. And look, here we go.
And look at all the lines. Look at these guys just running the high side all around here, stack up. We see Robbie just kind of slow right around that cone.
Scotty Steele in his bright red number 5 SST Traxxas truck jumps out to the lead big time after the stack up. Look at it. Pushing and shoving, Abdali Lopez in the green, white, and red involved.
Vanis involved over there. Here we're on board with Scotty Steele.
Gordon tries to go down to the inside in his Speed Energy truck.
Literally has to park the car as they all get stacked up there.
One more look at it.
Big lock up from Abdali Lopez. He gets sideways. He bumps the back of Scotty Steele, but Scotty Steele gets a great shot and takes the lead coming off of there.
On board with Abdali Lopez, he gets into the side of several of the vehicles, including Sheldon Green. I think Keegan Kincaid is going, come on, guys, give me a break. But for Scotty Steele, from third to first at the start, can the youngster hang on and win his first Formula Off-Road event? Speed Energy Formula Off-Road is brought to you by Traxxas, the fastest name in radio control. And by Toyo Tires, driven to perform. Race 1 from the Coronado Speed Festival, Formula Off-Road, presented by Traxxas, underway. The youngster, Scotty Steele, 16 years old, up front and leading this field right now.
This is a great shot. Look at the difference of where we were last night to now. We're on this concrete pavement, big speed. Look at the movement of the trucks under braking. This is that back straightaway, about 130 miles as it approaching these tires. And look at this tricycle coming off there, just nailing the gas and ride it out and have the confidence that I can give it the throttle, it's gonna come back down.
EJ Viso beginning to close the distance, and you would expect EJ Viso, the former IndyCar driver, actually still a current IndyCar driver when he gets an opportunity, putting the pressure on him. That means he knows road course racing better than Scotty Steele. Steele comes from dirt, he's a dirt track racer, and on top of that, he's 16 years old. He doesn't have nearly the experience that EJ Viso has. Doing a good job to hold his own, but you'd think Viso would have the upper hand.
You would think, but Scotty, that's been his program all year, is he's racing everything he can, just bringing that learning curve along. And, you know, EJ's going to be there pressuring him. EJ's got a little white hood on that from last night.
DOT approved Toyo tires. And, oh, contact down in turn one. Robbie Gordon is a part of it.
Lopez is. Kincaid is. Look at that. Look at the big speed. Robbie just coming in there, locks it up, and uses Abdali, I think, really as the brake once he gets in there.
Oh, yeah. I think Robbie would even tell you he just got in there way, way too quickly. Locks the rear end on board with Abdali Lopez. He thinks everything's fine.
He's rolling into the corner now. Where's the impact?
But
there
it is. Where
did
that come from? A rare mistake by Robbie Gordon. Gets a little loose, and Gordon drops well back in the order, almost to the back. And how much damage does he have? A little bit of body work. That's not at all uncommon in this series. That won't slow him down, but does he have any suspension damage after that hard contact?
Well, keep in mind, right now, these guys are really in this race now, learning this racetrack. They've had very little time here. You know, the team has done a great job. Look, we got a battle for the lead. EJ looking down the inside. It's not gonna happen. Scotty, great job.
EJ Viso shifting gears, the lever on the left, the gear shift, the lever on the right, a turning brake, locks the rear ends.
And there he's got it.
Done. Gets it done. EJ Viso goes to the lead.
But a great opportunity now. Scotty needs to latch onto his rear bumper and just follow him, figure out where he's a little bit quicker, where he's a little bit slower, and just kind of refine his line as they're learning around this racetrack. Like I say, they just got here this morning, so these guys, fantastic air shot there. How about that? That's just in
talk
the trunk
about,
of that truck.
Man, talk about landing here at the Naval Air Station. You just saw it. I think perhaps a little bit of setup differences on the truck. Here's the pass for the lead, EJ Biso. Gets a better shot, goes around the outside.
Yeah, just kind of rolled that speed on the outside, for sure.
Robbie Gordon trying to work his way back. A little bit of smoke from the left rear of Robbie Gordon. Speed Energy SST Traxxas truck.
And as these drivers are approaching this turn one, again, they're trying to get some references of where is the good braking point. How can they deep can they get in under the brake pedal?
Well, and go back to these are DOT approved Toyo tires. They're the same tires that you would buy at the tire store down the way, and they are taking punishment here on these concrete runways and taxiways. On board with Abdali Lopez.
And look at that, a little bit of bumping with Burt Jenner in the Gladiator tire truck.
Jenner, we talked about him at the beginning, doing such a great job improving every weekend. And he had a great run at the Sand Sports Super Show, just cut down a tire in race number two there. That cost him, but improving every weekend for EJ Biso, he's been spectacular, especially on the street type circuits.
No, and that's his home, so you'd expect him to be good at that. But where he's really good is just adapting to these trucks and just the different style of that. And I think it's an aggressive style. It's not as much, so much about road racing, if you come from sports car racing, of being precise. You got to be a little wider and wide open, and EJ brings that. You never know what he's going to do from one turn to the next in terms of his aggressiveness and just driving it in there hard.
Well, and I think there is a different setup on the trucks for Scotty Steele and EJ Biso. You see Scotty Steele really pick up the inside front tire a lot. EJ Biso's truck much flatter across the front. The front, right front or inside front will come off the ground. Oh, that is tight.
And he looks over at him right there, and Scotty, and he got that position. Creed, that was Sheldon Creed, got that position on Scotty Steele. But you make a good point, is we see Scotty really lifting that inside tire, and that just could be a softer rear end, a softer bar, a little damage there on Abdali Lopez Visit Mexico car.
On board with Dave Royce, his very first ever Formula off-road race. This is a guy who used to work on Group 7 trucks back when the Mickey Thompson series was running. He said that's what he really wanted to do, but it was too expensive to get into, so he went sports car racing. Well, guess what? Now Robbie Gordon and the Speed Energy Formula Off-Road Series presented by Traxxas is a much more affordable way to go racing. Dave Roy says, this is where I want to be. He's planning on running a full season next year.
And it worked out pretty well. He is actually subbing for Aaron Baumbach that hurt himself just going off of one of the jumps and just landed funny, just tweaked his back a little bit at the Sandsport event. So great that Dave can fill in, because this is where he wants to be all next year.
Yeah, he was out here to watch anyway, so he's taking over the discount tire truck. And Aaron's injury actually was a re-injury from a sports car crash. So there you have it. Right now, though, out in front, EJ Biso, Robbie Gordon trying to charge forward. Next on his list, it's going to be Keegan Kincaid trying to make up the positions lost there with that spin down in turn one.
And you have to love the double ramps right along start finish. You got all the fans running up to the fence. They got their phones just videoing the jumps, and these guys are hitting those speeds, and they're launching up to close to 200 feet long coming off these ramps.
Absolutely spectacular racing. The white flag is out for EJ Biso. Just about a half a lap to go in the back part of the course right now. Half a lap, but another five corners and three jumps the way I see it, Robbie.
Yeah, and he's got nobody breathing on him, so he just got to bring this home, think about what he's got to do for the next race.
Well, you want to make sure that you save your truck. You know you've got race number two coming up, and you want to make sure you save the tires, those Toyo tires. Punished right now. Amazing they hold up like they do. But for EJ Biso, looking for another victory in the Formula Off-Road Series presented by Traxxas.
There he is. Now there he's making the right-hander coming onto the front race. We've got double jump, and he's going to be coming right to the checker. We're on board with EJ right there.
And a great shot of the crowds in the grandstand. And you can see just how high they jump. And look at this. It is not over until it's over.
Lopez just absolutely leaning on Jenners. They come onto the front straightaway, takes that position as they hit the double jumps.
And I think Robbie Gordon was going to try to sneak through, but that door got closed by the two trucks in front of him. Great onboard shows just how far these trucks jump. Fans on their feet at the checkered flag. We'll be back to hear from our winner right after this. Race number one for Speed Energy Formula Off-Road presented by Traxxas in the books from here at the Coronado Speed Festival and Naval Air Station, North Island. For EJ Vizo, he avoided the problems down in turn one at the hairpin at the start. Comes away with a victory, but most importantly, Sheldon Creed, at least for the championship, Sheldon Creed finishes well in front of Robbie Gordon.
Yep, and closes in on the points gap, and let's see what he can pull out in race two here.
Let's hear from EJ Vizo. He's with Taylor.
EJ Vizo taking home the win here in Stadium Super Trucks at the Coronado Speed Festival. EJ, I know you've been a tough competitor in this series, but it's definitely got to be a special win here today in front of all of these military members.
Well, it's definitely an amazing venue here. It's pretty incredible. It reminds me in the days that I did the Woodwood Festival back in England, all the different categories, the amazing cars. And well, to be driving one of these beasts, jumping all around and putting it sideways and next to the other competitors, which are making my life very difficult. It's fun to come in first, and now we're looking onto the finale that is in a couple of hours.
All right, well, best of luck to you in the final, and we can't wait to see EJ Vizo, one of our strong road competitors, going to be a tough one to battle in the second round.
Oh, he will definitely be one tough customer. We talk about the points and how important it was for Sheldon Creed. He's closed back in on Robbie Gordon. And speaking of Sheldon Creed, let's hear from the youngster.
Sheldon Creed, one of our youngest competitors in the Stadium Super Trucks class, taking second place. Sheldon, you've got a tough competitor up front, EJ. He's known for road racing. You're known for off-road racing. So how was it battling someone from a different type?
Yeah, he's definitely really good at these asphalt races. And I came from the back, got up to the front, and felt good with the second place. Just got another race to go to today. And another Traxxas truck was on fire today. So I just got to thank all them, and now we're ready.
And what do you think about this track out here? It's obviously a great place. I know you're from California, so it's got to be great racing in your home state with this beautiful sunshine and great fans.
Yeah, pretty cool from being from San Diego and racing in San Diego. So, no, it's a pretty cool track set up out here, and now I'm ready for the next race.
Well, we'll see if this hometown racer can get that win in the second round today.
Sheldon Creed, 16. Scotty Steele, 16. Add them together, that's still younger than you or me, Robbie.
Yeah, kind of crazy. I mean, look at these guys do battle. We're on board with Scotty Steele there, looking ahead at Sheldon Creed. Let's hear from Scotty of what he has to say.
Scotty Steele finishing third today in the Stadium Super Truck race. Scotty, you've proved yourself to be one tough competitor out here, no matter the age. We have one more round coming up. What is your strategy going into this?
I'm just going to try to work on my lines, hitting my marks. I was messing up a little bit in the chicane, and EJ was talking to me about it, and that should hopefully help me and move me up a few spots up here so maybe I can get my first win in the series.
And what do you think about these jumps running on asphalt? You're also an off-road racer, but it's great to be out here on the Naval Base running on their turf.
Oh, it's great. It's such an honor to be out here. I mean, this is their area. I'm going to treat it with as much respect as I can. It's an honor to be here.
All right, well, great sportsmanship out of all of these racers, and we're going to find out just how great their racing battles are in this next round of Stadium Super Trucks.
That's right, Taylor, race number two coming up. Can Sheldon Creed continue to close down on Robbie Gordon's points lead? Welcome back to Speed Energy Formula Off-Road, presented by Traxxas. The Coronado Speed Festival well underway. Race number one in the books, race number two coming up. It's going to have a very different complexion to it, Robbie.
It sure is, Brian. First of all, it's going to have a little different layout in terms of how the cars go through one and two. Very different. From there, we're going to have a competition yellow. But to really make it exciting, we're going to have a joker lap. But you can't take that joker lap until you've had the competition yellow. After that, then you can strategize as when's the best time to take that joker lap. So here, we're heading down to turn one. That's where we had all the chaos in race one in the hairpin. Going back straightaway, that's the tire chicane where we saw a lot of tricycling lifting the wheels. Here as we come back towards the fan-friendly area where they can see all the jumps. Now, this is where it's really interesting. There's the Joker lap. So you go past our finish. There'll be cones designated that you have to get to the right side of the front straightaway, and then that shortens the track by about 12 seconds, give or take, is what that Joker gets you.
And that's where the strategy comes in. This is how they'll line up. Charles Dorrance on the pole. Alongside of him, Bruce Canepa. Bruce, new to the series, but not to racing. A sports car racer from a ways back. He certainly has experience in race cars. What about trucks?
Inside row three, Nick Vanis with a lot of jet ski background along Scotty Steele. And we know Scotty just keeps getting better with every race.
Dave Royce and Keegan Kincaid fill out row three, then back to row four, Abdali Lopez and Sheldon Creed.
And from there, Bert Jenner, Robbie Gordon, with EJ Vizo, who's starting at the back, and he's been coming on strong.
And you see the onboard with Vizo and Robbie Gordon. Gordon giving everybody the thumbs up, saying, hey, I'm ready to get this underway. Then to Bert Jenner. We talk about his improvement. We'll see how he runs on this new layout here.
Sheldon Creed, great to have him back. Obviously, he showed what he can do in race one here. Can he win this race and get some points and put that spread on Robbie Gordon?
Abdali Lopez was a bit of a punching bag a little bit earlier in race number one. He wants to make amends. And then Keegan Kincaid, he too has been very strong at the Super Sports Show. Then Dave Royce.
Filling in for Aaron Baumbach in the discount tire car.
Dave Royce excited about the future here. Scotty Steele, well, he is looking to move forward as well. And to do it, he'll be coming from row number two. Nick Vanis inside row two, and then to the front row, the guys that'll have the best shot out in front. There's Bruce Canepa. You ride on board with him, and he's got to be excited about what he's got in front of him and a little worried about what's behind. And then Charles Dorrance up front.
And remember, as we're about to take the green flag here, looking off to the left there, right on the wall, that's where we're going to see that green flag. Remember what we saw in race one. It was chaos because it was a big hairpin. Now it's more of a 90-degree corner.
And it's a longer run down to turn one than it was before. Green flag wave. We're racing. Two of the lesser experienced drivers up front. Let's see how long it takes before they are swallowed up by the competition down in turn one.
Well, for Bruce Canepa, this is his very first outing here. So here he's got that whole field behind him as he's going to the brake pedal right now in turn one. And he's got the lead in that yellow truck.
You got to give it to Bruce way out in front here at the start. But we still have a long, long way to go. Scotty Steele. Oh, and Canepa already with a problem.
Just as you say that, as he was just coming off of turn two, just putting down that 600 horsepower, just lit him up and around her went. Scotty Steele tricycling as he's coming off, heading towards turn three.
You can see how soft some of these drivers are running these cars suspension-wise. That's why that inside front tire picks up. It's just hard. These trucks, short wheelbase, narrow track, and for Bruce Canepa, 600 horsepower. Hard to get a feel for just what it's like.
And again, that Tayo tire is a street tire, so it's not some sticky race compound that you just can mash the gas and it's gonna hook up and drive you. You gotta feather that throttle.
Shows how difficult these trucks are. So when you're watching these drivers get the most out of them, they are really, really working. Right now, Scotty Steele working hard as he leads the field into the chicane on the back.
Look at the difference in the truck setup right there between Kincaid and Scotty Steele. Scotty's just inside wheel way picking up. EJ, he wants to get by Robbie.
Oh, inside?
And I think he is by him. We don't see Robbie off on the left side right now.
Dave Royce, you saw him out to the side in the discount tire truck having a bit of an issue. But, man, EJ Vizo on a charge yet again.
On board with Keegan Kincaid coming to the front straightaway. He's chasing down Scotty Steele right there. Kincaid really done a great job as a short track dirt guy. Look at how he's doing on this pavement.
Woo! A little hard off the landing, but right now, Scotty Steele leads from San Diego. Can he find his first victory of the season? Speed Energy Formula Off-Road is brought to you by Traxxas, the fastest name in radio control. And by Toyo Tires, driven to perform. 16-year-old Scotty Steele continuing to lead in race number two from the Coronado Speed Festival. Speed Energy Formula Off-Road presented by Traxxas. They are on it right here in race number two. Championship implications for Sheldon Creed. He's trying to move forward. But Scotty Steele doing a great job holding down the point right now from intense pressure from Keegan Kincaid in that blue and gray Traxxas truck right behind.
And the red and gray Traxxas truck right there is Sheldon Creed. And I think back the first time I saw Sheldon Creed, it was 2013 Toronto, a spin in the back.
Abdali Lopez.
That was kind of a courtesy spin to the original spin. That was EJ Vizo.
Abdali Lopez and EJ Vizo in each other again. Look
four
at
way.
This.
Side by side off the jump. That is Burt Jenner that's climbed up to the back of these guys.
Sheldon Creed now up to second.
Look at
really
him right,
putting the pressure on.
Right on his tail coming off that jump.
Here's a replay of the spin. Abdali Lopez into the side of EJ Vizo, and that might have been a little payback for what we saw at the Sand Sports Super Show just last night. This is on board with EJ Vizo.
There is that hit from Lopez. So it really looked like when we first saw that, it looked like EJ spun all on his own. But no, he was helped by Lopez, and then Lopez did the courtesy spin to his pack.
Yeah, a little love tap there, and actually not a lot of love in it, but this is intense up front. On board with Sheldon Creed, he just took the lead from Scotty Steele.
And before all that craziness started for that challenge for the lead, I was going to say, when I first saw Creed was 2013 in Toronto, and this kid was just launching big time off these steel jumps. But he also won there on the streets and the pavement, the curbs. Just shows you his talent and his ability. You think he's a dirt guy, but no, he knows pavement. Look at that tricycle.
Scotty Steele just lost another position, I think. It's one of those deals where right now, perhaps the handling of the truck going away, maybe he's punished those Toyo tires a little much. As Burt Jenner, we've talked about how much that young man has improved. He's now picked up yet another position in his Gladiator truck.
And to mention Burt Jenner, I mean, you know, he's the 2013 Octane Academy winner. So there's people that picked him for that, said that he's talented. This guy needs a shot.
Well, I think he needs a little bit of luck, too. Inexperience will cause you to have some bad luck sometimes, let's say. But he's also had a couple of issues that weren't of his making. So right now we're getting to see his talent really shine. Sheldon Creed shining out in front, but right behind him, Keegan Kincaid. But you got to think, Traxxas teammates, Keegan Kincaid knows that Sheldon Creed needs to take maximum points away from here if he has any hope of chasing down Robbie Gordon in the championship.
So are you saying that maybe he's going to help protect Sheldon a little bit and just let him have it? I don't think so. I think he's going to get up there and say, I'm here. I'm here to win.
I think he wants it, but I think Keegan Kincaid's pretty smart and understands that they both race for the sponsor, Traxxas. So perhaps it's important that Sheldon Creed has a shot at winning this championship.
And we were just on board there with Sheldon Creed. You just see him working that brake lever. Oh, man, that is to keep your foot in it as you come off.
Look
there
at Robbie
just
Gordon.
Confident.
Robbie Gordon now working his way past Scotty Steele. On board with Gordon. Really putting the pressure on Steele. Dropping back. I think perhaps he's just overheated those tires, Robbie.
Yeah, and you know, when we see him really picking up that incident, is he getting too much roll in the rear of the car where it's just laying over and just doesn't allow him point off the corner as well?
Sheldon Creed, Keegan Kincaid, then
Burt
Jenner with a great, great run. Jenner may have something for the two in front. Gordon still struggling a little bit to get past Scotty Steele, but EJ Vizo now at the back of Scotty Steele as well.
Okay, we've got a lot of great racing, but don't do anything to compromise your truck, hurt your truck. We still have a competition yellow that's coming up here, so it's going to just bring everybody back together.
Wow! Contact in the air between Scotty Steele and EJ Vizo, and you bring up a very valid point. Scotty Steele just needs to hold on. That competition caution will give him two things, a chance to cool things down a little bit and then a chance to strategize about using the Joker lane.
How about EJ Vizo not holding back and just passes him and hits the ramp together and says, see you later through the air, is the front straightaway.
You know, going wheel to wheel on the track is one thing. Going wheel to wheel over those jumps and in the air is something
fantastic.
Entirely different.
Fantastic.
Sheldon Creed leading the field, racing back to the competition caution. It should be out this lap, and everybody will have a chance to just settle things down a little bit, cool those tires, and off you go. And Talk about cooling the tires. I keep going back to, I'm so impressed with the tire that Toyo provides for these guys. It's the same tire you can put on your truck at home. Punished right now on these concrete runways in some pretty high temperatures, so they'll take a chance to settle those back down. And a lot of it is, Robbie, that it's a fully treaded tire. They haven't been shaved, and those tread blocks move back and forth under these racing conditions can really heat up.
I mean, it could make it a real challenge as a driver, but along with the tires taking the abuse is these SST Traxxas trucks. I mean, these guys hammer them. They hammer each other. But you don't see them pulling over because they're breaking down. They still run them.
Racing back to the competition caution, Sheldon
Big Pete, air.
Keegan Kincaid, Bert Jenner, then Robbie Gordon. That's the top four. And there's the yellow flag off to the left. Sheldon Creed desperately trying to stay in this championship hunt. No reason to save anything anymore if you're driving in the Speed Energy Formula Off-Road Series presented by Traxxas. For Sheldon Creed out in front, he can't conserve anymore. We're about to go back to green. He needs to make hay and put some distance between himself and Robbie Gordon in that bright orange Speed Energy Traxxas truck, fourth in the serial right now. Sheldon Creed trying to close the points gap in the championship to Robbie Gordon as we're about to go back to green. And remember, the Joker lane will come into play in the second half of this event.
That Joker lane, you have to get to the right side to start finish right after these double jumps. There's that cone. So go to the right side of that as the driver's approaching. Gordon takes it
immediately as soon as the green flag comes out. Robbie Gordon to the inside in the inside lane. It'll be a tight 180-degree corner as the rest of the field streams by. Dave Royce takes the Joker as well.
And I'm guessing it probably is going to shave about 12 seconds off their lap. We're on board with Robbie Gordon. You can see he looked over just to reference where the rest of the field was.
It's a high-speed re-entry there, so he needs to do that. It is intense back in the back. Scotty Steele and Dally Lopez going at it side by side. On board with Keegan Kincaid. What these two drivers need to worry about is just up in front of them. You see that little dot? That's Dave Royce. If they catch him in one of the tighter areas of the racetrack, it's going to allow Robbie Gordon to extend his lead.
And I think the one guy that really has to capitalize on when to take the Joker, there's a little tire barrier knocked out of the way, but it's Bert Jenner, who's right behind these two guys right here, because he's maybe being slowed up. So do I take the Joker so I have clean track in front? Like you said, right now, Keegan Kincaid and Sheldon Creed doesn't have anybody in front of him, but is he trying to slow? Is he getting slowed up trying to keep Kincaid behind him? When's the best time to take that Joker?
Dave Roy's actually doing a good job through the 7-8-9 complex, not holding him up at all. They may get by him on the straightaway, and that's really where you want to get it done, because that won't impede your progress at all. Dave Royce, first truck in your shot in that discount tire truck. Then Sheldon Creed, and on board Keegan Kincaid. He'll now go to the Joker lane.
And watch him down to first gear here. He's got his hand on the handbrake, just locking up that rear, help turn the car around, and off he goes. So now, where is Kincaid going to come out relative to Robbie Gordon? And there's the answer. Yeah. Robbie Gordon has gapped him by probably 10 car lengths.
Robbie Gordon has set sail because he was just in front of Keegan Kincaid and Sheldon Creed when he opted to take that Joker lane at the beginning. And man, he has put a tremendous distance between himself and Kincaid. What's Sheldon Creed got?
Well, we're going to find out when he takes that Joker, but obviously Robbie having that clean lap right from the get-go allowed him to get what Kincaid and Sheldon Creed were doing battle.
Well, I can tell you what, as open as this racetrack is, the other thing that it enables the competitors to do is see their competition. Sheldon Creed knows exactly what's going on. He's the third truck in your shot. He can see all the way up to Robbie Gordon. This is when Gordon took the Joker.
Okay, so
right at the start.
Right at the start. So we know right when he re-merges back into the racetrack and looks over, he had that gap. There's Robbie. Look at that last minute tush. You wonder if he says, hey, the guys in front of me didn't go. That surprises me. In I go.
Well, and think about it. They elected to go straight. He was like, I don't want to get hung up down in turn one. Maybe I can get an advantage doing this. But Sheldon Creed knows exactly where that bright Speed Energy truck is. He can see him across the runways. For Bruce Canepa, a problem. I think it's Nick Vanis got into the back of him over in turn six. In fact, it is Vanis in the Icon Reps Traxxas SST vehicle. A problem there, but they're both back underway. And here comes Sheldon Creed onto the front straightaway. But He can see that bright orange truck of Robbie Gordon up in front, and that doesn't bode well for him. He's trying to catch him in the points. He needs to be ahead of him on the racetrack.
And remember, for Sheldon, when is the time to take that joker lap? And sure enough, there we see him
there
right down
there.
He hit that perfectly in terms of just getting around that 180 launch. So where is he going to size up versus Robbie? There's our answer already.
You can see.
He's got a gap.
He's going to come in there in second, but it's a long way back. And you've got to wonder, and hindsight's always 20-20, isn't it, Robbie? I mean, you got to wonder, should he have done it right at the start? A lot of times in these races, when the joker's available, if you're leading at the start, just take it, burn it early.
I get now the answer to that is yes, he should have, right? Yes, you. But you know, you talk about the competitors being able to see where each other is on this track. It also is a great racetrack for the fans, so they can see all across this venue. They can see who's quick where, and they really get a sense of the speed of these trucks doing 130 miles an hour on that back straightaway as they're up in the grandstands. You really see the plus minus, who's faster where, who's slower where, who gains on who.
Well, and I think, too, that when they're out there, they probably look like the real Traxxas truck, the radio control trucks, because I'm sure they look very diminutive when they're way out there on the runway. But you said it, speeds well over 130 miles an hour down the straightaways, and the height of the jump probably approaching 25 or 30 feet. But for Robbie Gordon, he's doing what he needs to do. He's out in front.
And it's not just the impressive height off of these little metal jumps. It's the distance. They're going 200 feet long before they're coming down and hitting hard on this flat pavement.
I was going to say, you call them little metal jumps. I noticed that you've turned down your invitation to go over.
That's wrong to say little metal jumps because I'm not out there approaching. But it's very different versus that big crossover jump that we saw at Sandsport.
Absolutely.
That's why I say it that way, because that's wrong. Thank you for clarifying that.
Robbie Gordon, Sheldon Creed, Keegan Kincaid. That is the top three right now. And I think Sheldon Creed is closing the gap a little bit, but Robbie Gordon, an absolute master. He knows that all he has to do is stay in front. It doesn't matter whether it's one truck or 10. As long as he's leading at the checkered flag, he'll extend his points lead.
Yeah, I mean, coming, you know, what else do you got in your little briefcase right now, Sheldon Creed, that you can throw at Robbie Gordon? And that's tough to make that gap up right now.
Looking back through the fourth truck in line, Burt Jenner. In his Gladiator tires, Traxxas SST. Talk all race long about what a great job he's doing. A very, very solid run in the top four. Sheldon Creed digging. So is Keegan Kincaid right behind him in his blue and gray Traxxas machine. But the white flag is out, and for Robbie Gordon, just one more lap, and he'll take yet another victory and extend his points lead. Three down in turn one.
But no question, you know, here we are on Creed there looking up at Robbie Gordon. But Robbie Gordon's experience when it comes to asphalt and different kinds of asphalts and cone tracks versus tracks with walls, cement walls, and fencing, he does have that experience more so than Sheldon Creed, who's 16 years old and just as flat out never gives up.
Sheldon Creed on it big time. You can tell from the onboard that the inside front tire well off the ground. But you think about Robbie Gordon, his Dakar experience, IndyCar experience, NASCAR experience, all kinds of off-road truck experience. So you put all that together and you do have the complete package, Robbie, just like you said.
And again, this series, it's really neat to see, you know, guys from all walks, from off-road, from sports car, from open wheel, they all can come here and adapt to these trucks and be competitive. They're all identically prepared trucks making 600 horsepower. Look at that. You think the fans are loving that as they're up here just cheering them on?
Robbie Gordon having a little bit of fun now. Keegan Kincaid closing down on the rear bumper of his teammate. Gives him a little bump, but for Robbie Gordon, just a couple of more jumps. Win number five for Robbie Gordon in the Speed Energy Formula Off-Road Series presented by Traxxas. Robbie Gordon holds on to his points lead.
And Sheldon Creed absolutely just holds off Kincaid right there at the line. I think they were just having some fun for the fans.
Good stuff. Fans on their feet. Not a dull moment at all. And for Robbie Gordon, celebration time. We'll hear from him when we come back. Robbie Gordon does indeed claim victory number five in 2014 and holds on to his points championship here in Speed Energy Formula Off-Road presented by Traxxas. That's an angle you don't normally see. Sheldon Creed doing a little celebration after the checkered flag. I knew the kid was good, but a lap around the racetrack here on two wheels.
Again, 16 years old. And
so where does your 16-year-old learn to do this?
Well, I don't know. I can't answer that. But this 16-year-old, look at the talent. He felt the side coming down. He said, okay, I get a little gas and get it back up. But okay, remember, this is 1.7 miles around here. Let's see how
right
far.
Right and left,
gets.
Right and left. Hey, and remember the tires we were talking about earlier, the Toyo tires and how they held up and the tread blocks and all that? He's not running on the tread blocks now. He's running a 3,000-pound truck on the sidewall of the tire. That doesn't even look possible.
I think Robbie.
He's more than.
Robbie's definitely
look
taking
at the
index.
Look at
everybody.
The fans. That is absolutely fantastic.
Really cool. Really cool.
A complete lap on two wheels. Now the results, though. Robbie Gordon keeps that orange number plate because he wins here. Sheldon Creed, everything he could do. He just needed a few more seconds down the road. He may think about when he should have taken that Joker lap.
Yeah, and Burt Jenner, he's really showing in the Southern California races here what he's doing. Lopez is great. Scotty Steele has really come alive as well.
For Robbie Gordon, he's celebrating with Taylor.
Robbie Gordon taking home the first place finish here at Stadium Super Trucks at the Coronado Speed Festival. Robbie, you made a crucial move out there, and that was to take that Joker lane early after the mandatory caution. Do you think that really played off for you?
Oh, for sure it did. You know, when I was able to take it and have clean track, I was able to not just focus on outside, inside, outside, where the other guys were having to block and protect their line. So that was a crucial move. And I wasn't going to take it unless nobody else didn't take it. So when the first three left it open, I'm like, I'm taking it now. And I didn't know where we were going to pop out with the other guys. We popped out in front with clean racetrack, and that was the difference for sure.
And it's also got to be great racing here on the asphalt, of course, but of course on the naval base.
Yeah, it's a great honor to be here on the base. You know, this is an event that we look forward to coming to this year, and we're excited we came. We had great fans here today, and it was just a lot of fun.
Well, you definitely put on a great show for not only fans, but for those at home. Robbie Gordon taking home first in the Stadium Super Trucks race.
And congratulations to Robbie. Coronado Speed Festival, they've run this for 17 years, the first time for Speed Energy Formula Off-Road. 20,000 active duty military here on this base, over 4,000 civilian employees, and the general public invited in just one day a year, and it's for the Coronado Speed Festival. Robbie Gordon takes the victory. Sheldon Creed slips back a little bit in the points. I know he's disappointed with the finish, but still, it was a great run for the youngster. Let's hear from him.
Sheldon Creed finishing second in today's Stadium Super Truck race. Sheldon, you made some great moves out there. Those passes were crucial in order to get you onto this podium today. Where was the best place for you to make a pass?
I'd say this front straightaway. I carry a lot more speed than most people over the jump. So that's where I was setting up a lot of passes and ended up turn one. So it was actually pretty tough out there. There's some pretty stacked class out there. And now I'm just pumped to be up here. And now I'm with my Traxxas teammate, Keegan.
And this is a really legendary place to be. It's got to be special. We talked earlier, you're the hometown favorite out here, and you got yourself up on the podium again today for your fans.
Yeah, it's pretty cool being a hometown, San Diego. So, no, I'm pumped to be up here, second place, and no, it's cool being on the Traxxas truck.
Sheldon Creed finishing second.
Finishing second. He's getting older. He's going to have a birthday pretty soon. But here is a great battle. Keegan Kincaid trying to get past Sheldon Creed to the end.
Fantastic. Look at this side by side hitting this last ramp right before the fans there. Great.
Just impressive stuff and shows a lot of trust. Let's hear from Keegan.
Keegan Kincaid finishing third in today's race in that Traxxas truck. Keegan, you were battling with your teammate Sheldon Creed. It was just like those RCs out there, back and forth, back and forth. What was your strategy? Were you helping your teammate or were you ready to go 100%?
You know, we were racing clean and I didn't want to take him out and I knew he wouldn't take me out, but that last lap, I was going for it, and we were out front. We were leading me. The two Traxxas trucks were out front and pulling away, and Robbie just took the Joker lane at the right time and got ahead of us while me and Sheldon were battling. And we came out almost dead even on that Joker lane, me and Sheldon, and it was a race to the finish, but I couldn't be happier to put these Traxxas trucks up on the podium today.
And how is it racing out here at the Naval Base? It's got to be a pretty special place with all these fans here.
Oh, yeah, this is amazing. You know, another one to add to my list of resume you know, we raced at Indy this year, and now we're here. I just can't believe I'm here racing with all these fans, you know, introducing them something new, and hopefully we can come back next year.
All right, well, the guy from the Midwest comes to the West Coast in podiums. Congratulations to Keegan Kincaid on third place.
Thank you, Taylor. Keegan Kincaid, very strong out here on the West Coast, both here and at the Sand Sports Super Show. Up next, it's going to be the finale, November 21st, 12:30 a.m. Eastern Time, 9:30 Pacific Time from Las Vegas. What a place to end the season.
A great place. That's during SEMA Show in Vegas, so everybody will be there. It'll be perfect. But how about this? Three fantastic days of racing in truck-crazy Mecca, Southern California, and it really is showing the diversity of this series and these trucks and the show they can put on, from the short stadium of dirt and asphalt to this flat, open 1.7-mile track of 130-mile-an-hour plus top speeds.
Entertainment value has been incredible. For Robbie Buell, Taylor Snyder, I'm Brian Till. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you next time in Las Vegas. Out in front here at the start, but we still have a long, long way to go. Scotty Steele, oh, and Kampa already with a problem.
Just as you say that, as he was just coming off of turn two, just putting down that 600 horsepower, just lit him up, and around it went. Scotty Steele tricycling as he's coming off, heading towards turn three.
You can see how soft some of these drivers are running these cars suspension-wise. That's why that inside front tire picks up. It's just hard. These trucks, short wheelbase, narrow track, and for Bruce Canepa, 600 horsepower, hard to get a feel for just what it's like.
And again, that Toyo tire is a street tire, so it's not some sticky race compound that you just can mash the gas and it's gonna hook up and drive you. You gotta feather that throttle.
Shows how difficult these trucks are, so when you're watching these drivers get the most out of them, they are really, really working. Right now, Scotty Steele working hard as he leads the field into the chicane on the back.
Look at the difference in the truck setup right there between Kincaid and Scotty Steele. Scotty's just inside wheel way picking up. EJ, he wants to get by Robbie.
Oh, inside?
And,
yeah.
And I think he is by him. We don't see Robbie off on the left side right now.
Dave Royce, you saw him out to the side in the discount tire truck having a bit of an issue. But, man, EJ Viso on a charge yet again.
On board with Keegan Kincaid coming to the front straightaway. He's chasing down Scotty Steele right there. Kincaid really done a great job as a short track dirt guy. Look at how he's doing on this pavement.
Woo! A little hard off the landing, but right now, Scotty Steele leads from San Diego. Can he find his first victory of the season? Speed Energy Formula Off-Road is brought to you by Traxxas, the fastest name in radio control. And by Toyo Tires, driven to perform. 16-year-old Scotty Steele continuing to lead in race number two from the Coronado Speed Festival. Speed Energy Formula Off-Road presented by Traxxas. They are on it right here in race number two. Championship implications for Sheldon Creed. He's trying to move forward, but Scotty Steele doing a great job holding down the point right now from intense pressure from Keegan Kincaid in that blue and gray Traxxas truck right behind.
And the red and gray Traxxas truck right there is Sheldon Creed. And I think back the first time I saw Sheldon Creed, it was 2013.
Whoa.
Toronto, a spin in the back.
Abdali Lopez.
That was kind of a courtesy spin to the original spin. That was EJ Viso.
Abdali Lopez and EJ Viso in each other again. Look
four
at
way.
This.
Side by side off the jump. That is Burt Jenner that's climbed up to the back of these guys.
Sheldon Creed now up to second.
Look at
really
him
really putting the pressure on.
Right on his tail coming off that jump.
Here's a replay of the spin. Abdali Lopez into the side of EJ Viso, and that might have been a little payback for what we saw at the Sand Sports Super Show just last night. This is on board with EJ Viso.
There Boom. Is that hit from Lopez. So it really looked like, when we first saw that, it looked like EJ spun all on his own, but no, he was held by Lopez, and then Lopez did the courtesy spin to his pack.
Yeah, a little love tap there, and actually not a lot of love in it, but this is intense up front. on board with Sheldon Creed. He just took the lead from Scotty Steele.
And before all that craziness started for that challenge for the lead, I was going to say, when I first saw Creed was 2013 in Toronto, and this kid was just launching big time off these steel jumps. But he also won there on the streets and the pavement, the curbs. Just shows you his talent and his ability. You think he's a dirt guy, but no, he knows pavement. Look at that tricycle.
Scotty Steele just lost another position, I think. It's one of those deals where right now, perhaps the handling of the truck going away, maybe he's punished those Toyo tires a little much. As Burt Jenner, we've talked about how much that young man has improved. He's now picked up yet another position in his Gladiator truck.
And to mention Burt Jenner, I mean, you know, he's the 2013 Octane Academy winner. So there's people that picked him for that, said that he's talented. This guy needs a shot.
Well, I think he needs a little bit of luck, too. Inexperience will cause you to have some bad luck sometimes, let's say. But he's also had a couple of issues that weren't of his making. So right now we're getting to see his talent really shine. Sheldon Creed shining out in front, but right behind him, Keegan Kincaid. But you got to think, Traxxas teammates, Keegan Kincaid knows that Sheldon Creed needs to take maximum points away from here if he has any hope of chasing down Robbie Gordon in the championship.
So are you saying that maybe he's going to help protect Sheldon a little bit and just let him have it? I don't think so. I think he's going to get up there and say, I'm here. I'm here to win.
I think he wants it, but I think Keegan Kincaid's pretty smart and understands that they both race for the sponsor, Traxxas. So perhaps it's important that Sheldon Creed has a shot at winning this championship.
And we were just on board there with Sheldon Creed. You just see him working that brake lever.
Oh,
man, that is to keep your foot in it as you come off.
Look
there.
Look at Robbie Gordon.
Confident.
Robbie Gordon now working his way past Scotty Steele. On board with Gordon. Really putting the pressure on Steele. Dropping back. I think perhaps he's just overheated those tires, Robbie.
Yeah, and you know, when we see him really picking up that incident, is he getting too much roll in the rear of the car where it's just laying over and just doesn't allow him to point off the corner as well?
Sheldon Creed, Keegan Kincaid, then
great
Burt
battle.
Jenner with a great, great run. Jenner may have something for the two in front. Gordon still struggling a little bit to get past Scotty Steele, but EJ Viso now at the back of Scotty Steele as well.
Okay, we've got a lot of great racing, but don't do anything to compromise your truck, hurt your truck. We still have a competition yellow that's coming up here, so it's gonna just bring everybody back together.
Wow! Contact in the air between Scotty Steele and EJ Viso, and you bring up a very valid point. Scotty Steele just needs to hold on. That competition caution will give him two things, a chance to cool things down a little bit and then a chance to strategize about using the Joker lane.
How about EJ Viso not holding back and just passes him and hits the ramp together and says, see you later through the air, is the front straightaway.
You know, going wheel to wheel on the track is one thing. Going wheel to wheel over those jumps and in the air is something
fantastic.
Entirely different.
Fantastic.
Sheldon Creed leading the field, racing back to the competition caution. It should be out this lap, and everybody will have a chance to just settle things down a little bit, cool those tires, and off you go. And talk about cooling the tires, I keep going back to, I'm so impressed with the tire that Toyo provides for these guys. It's the same tire you can put on your truck at home. Punished right now on these concrete runways in some pretty high temperatures, so they'll take a chance to settle those back down. And a lot of it is, Robbie, that it's a fully treaded tire. They haven't been shaved, and those tread blocks move back and forth under these racing conditions and can really heat up.
I mean, it can make it a real challenge as a driver, but along with the tires taking the abuse is these SST Traxxas trucks. I mean, these guys hammer them. They hammer each other, but you don't see them pulling over because they're breaking down. They still run them.
Racing back to the competition caution, Sheldon
Big Pete, air.
Keegan Kincaid, Burt Jenner, then Robbie Gordon. That's the top four, and there's the yellow flag off to the left. Sheldon Creed desperately trying to stay in this championship hunt. No reason to save anything anymore if you're driving in the Speed Energy Formula Off-Road Series presented by Traxxas. For Sheldon Creed out in front, he can't conserve anymore. We're about to go back to green. He needs to make hay and put some distance between himself and Robbie Gordon in that bright orange Speed Energy Traxxas truck, fourth in the serial right now. Sheldon Creed trying to close the points gap in the championship to Robbie Gordon as we're about to go back to green. And remember, the Joker Lane will come into play in the second half of this event.
That Joker Lane, you have to get to the right side to start finish right after these double jumps. There's that cone. So go to the right side of that as the driver's approaching. Gordon takes it
immediately as soon as the green flag comes out. Robbie Gordon to the inside in the inside lane. It'll be a tight 180-degree corner as the rest of the field streams by. Dave Royce takes the Joker as well.
And I'm guessing it probably is going to shave about 12 seconds off their lap. We're on board with Robbie Gordon. You can see he looked over just to reference where the rest of the field was.
It's a high-speed re-entry there, so he needs to do that. It is intense. Back in the back, Scotty Steele, Abdali Lopez going at it side by side. On board with Keegan Kincaid. What these two drivers need to worry about is just up in front of them, you see that little dot? That's Dave Royce. If they catch him in one of the tighter areas of the racetrack, it's going to allow Robbie Gordon to extend his lead.
And I think the one guy that really has to capitalize on when to take the Joker, there's a little tire barrier knocked out of the way, but it's Burt Jenner, who's right behind these two guys right here, because he's maybe being slowed up. So do I take the Joker so I have clean track in front? Like you said, right now, Keegan Kincaid and Sheldon Creed. Creed doesn't have anybody in front of him, but is he getting slowed up trying to keep Kincaid behind him? When's the best time to take that Joker?
Dave Roy's actually doing a good job through the 7-8-9 complex, not holding him up at all. They may get by him on the straightaway, and that's really where you want to get it done, because that won't impede your progress at all. Dave Royce, the first truck in your shot, in that discount tire truck. Then Sheldon Green, and on board Keegan Kincaid. He'll now go to the Joker lane.
And watch him down to first gear here. He's got his hand on the handbrake, just locking up that rear, help turn the car around, and off he goes. So now, where is Kincaid going to come out relative to Robbie Gordon? And there's the answer. Yeah. Robbie Gordon has gapped him by probably 10 car lengths.
Robbie Gordon has set sail because he was just in front of Keegan Kincaid and Sheldon Creed when he opted to take that Joker lane at the beginning. And man, he has put a tremendous distance between himself and Kincaid. What's Sheldon Creed got?
Well, we're going to find out when he takes that Joker. But obviously, Robbie having that clean lap right from the get-go allowed him to gap what Kincaid and Sheldon Creed were doing battle.
I can tell you what, as open as this racetrack is, the other thing that it enables the competitors to do is see their competition. Sheldon Creed knows exactly what's going on. He's the third truck in your shot. He can see all the way up to Robbie Gordon. This is when Gordon took the Joker.
Okay, so
right at the start.
Right at the start. So we know right when he re-merges back into the racetrack and looks over, he had that gap. There's Robbie. Look at that last minute tush. You wonder if he says, hey, the guys in front of me didn't go. That surprises me. In I go.
Well, and think about it. They elected to go straight. He was like, I don't want to get hung up down in turn one. Maybe I can get an advantage doing this. But Sheldon Creed knows exactly where that bright speed energy truck is. He can see him across the runways. For Bruce Canepa, a problem. I think it's Nick Vanis got into the back of him over in turn six. In fact, it is Vanis in the Icon Wraps Traxxas SST vehicle, a problem there, but they're both back underway. And here comes Sheldon Creed onto the front straightaway, but he can see that bright orange truck of Robbie Gordon up in front, and that doesn't bode well for him. He's trying to catch him in the points. He needs to be ahead of him on the racetrack.
And remember, for Sheldon, when is the time to take that Joker lap? And sure enough, there we see him
there
right
is.
Down
yep.
there. He hit that perfectly in terms of just getting around that 180 launch. So where is he going to size up versus Robbie? There's our answer already.
You can see.
He's got a gap.
He's going to come in there in second, but it's a long way back. And you've got to wonder, and hindsight's always 20-20, isn't it, Robbie? I mean, you got to wonder, should he have done it right at the start? A lot of times in these races, when the Joker's available, if you're leading at the start, just take it, burn it early.
I get now the answer to that is yes, you should have, right? Yes, you should. But you know, you talk about the competitors being able to see where each other is on this track. It also is a great racetrack for the fans, so they can see all across this venue. They can see who's quick where, and they really get a sense of the speed of these trucks doing 130 miles an hour on that back straightaway as they're up in the grandstands. You really see the plus minus, who's faster where, who's slower where, who gains on who.
Well, and I think, too, that when they're out there, they probably look like the real Traxxas truck, the radio control trucks, because I'm sure they look very diminutive when they're way out there on the runway, but you said it, speeds well over 130 miles an hour down the straightaways, and the height of the jump probably approaching 25 or 30 feet. But for Robbie Gordon, he's doing what he needs to do. He's out in front.
And it's not just the impressive height off of these little metal jumps. It's the distance. They're going 200 feet long before they're coming down and hitting hard on this flat pavement.
Going to say, you call them little metal jumps. I noticed that you've turned down your invitation to go over.
That's wrong to say little metal jumps because I'm not out there approaching. But it's very different versus that big crossover jump that we saw at Sandsport.
Absolutely.
That's why I say it that way, because that's wrong. Thank you for clarifying that.
Robbie Gordon, Sheldon Creed, Keegan Kincaid. That is the top three right now. And I think Sheldon Creed is closing the gap a little bit, but Robbie Gordon, an absolute master. He knows that all he has to do is stay in front. It doesn't matter whether it's one truck or 10. As long as he's leading at the checkered flag, he'll extend his points lead.
Yeah, I mean, coming, you know, what else do you got in your little briefcase right now, Sheldon Creed, that you can throw at Robbie Gordon? And that's tough to make that. He's just absolutely leaning on generous. They come onto the front straightaway, takes that position as they hit the double jumps.
And I think Robbie Gordon was going to try to sneak through, but that door got closed by the two trucks in front of him. Great onboard, so just how far these trucks jump. Fans on their feet at the checkered flag. We'll be back to hear from our winner right after this. Race number one for Speed Energy Formula Off-Road presented by Traxxas in the books from here at the Coronado Speed Festival and Naval Air Station, North Island. For EJ Vizo, he avoided the problems down in turn one at the hairpin at the start. Comes away with a victory, but most importantly, Sheldon Creed, at least for the championship, Sheldon Creed finishes well in front of Robbie Gordon.
Yep, and closes in on the points gap, and let's see what he can pull out in race two here.
Let's hear from EJ Vizo. He's with Taylor.
EJ Vizo taking home the win here in Stadium Super Trucks at the Coronado Speed Festival. EJ, I know you've been a tough competitor in this series, but it's definitely got to be a special win here today in front of all of these military members.
Well, it's definitely an amazing venue here. It's pretty incredible. It reminds me in the days that I did the Goodwood Festival back in England, all the different categories, the amazing cars. And well, to be driving one of these beasts, jumping all around and putting it sideways next to the other competitors, which are making my life very difficult. It's fun to come in first, and now we're looking onto the finale that is in a couple of hours.
All right, well, best of luck to you in the final, and we can't wait to see EJ Vizo, one of our strong road competitors, going to be a tough one to battle in the second round.
Oh, he will definitely be one tough customer. We talk about the points and how important it was for Sheldon Creed. He's closed back in on Robbie Gordon. And speaking of Sheldon Creed, let's hear from the youngster.
Sheldon Creed, one of our youngest competitors in the Stadium Super Trucks class, taking second place. Sheldon, you've got a tough competitor up front, EJ. He's known for road racing. You're known for off-road racing. So how was it battling someone from a different type?
Yeah, he's definitely really good at these asphalt races. And I came from the back, got up to the front, and felt good with the second place. Just got another race to go to today. And this Traxxas truck was on fire today. So I just got to thank all them, and now we're ready.
And what do you think about this track out here? It's obviously a great place. I know you're from California, so it's got to be great racing in your home state with this beautiful sunshine and great fans.
Yeah, pretty cool from being from San Diego and racing in San Diego. So no, it's a pretty cool track set up out here, and now I'm ready for the next race.
Well, we'll see if this hometown racer can get that win in the second round today.
Sheldon Creed, 16. Scotty Steele, 16. Add them together, that's still younger than you or me, Robbie.
Yeah, kind of crazy. I mean, look at these guys do battle. We're on board with Scotty Steele there, looking ahead at Sheldon Creed. Let's hear from Scotty of what he has to say.
Scotty Steele finishing third today in the Stadium Super Truck race. Scotty, you've proved yourself to be one tough competitor out here, no matter the age. We have one more round coming up. What is your strategy going into this?
I'm just going to try to work on my lines, hitting my marks. I was messing up a little bit in the chicane, and EJ was talking to me about it, and that should hopefully help me and move me up a few spots up here so maybe I can get my first win in the series.
And what do you think about these jumps running on asphalt? You're also an off-road racer, but it's great to be out here on the Naval Base running on their turf.
Oh, it's great. It's such an honor to be out here. I mean, this is their area. I'm going to treat it with as much respect as I can. It's an honor to be here.
All right, well, great sportsmanship out of all of these racers, and we're going to find out just how great their racing battles are in this next round of Stadium Super Trucks.
That's right, Taylor, race number two coming up. Can Sheldon Creed continue to close down on Robbie Gordon's points lead? Welcome back to Speed Energy Formula Off-Road, presented by Traxxas. The Coronado Speed Festival well underway. Race number one in the books, race number two coming up. It's going to have a very different complexion to it, Robbie.
It sure is, Brian. First of all, it's going to have a little different layout in terms of how the cars go through one and two. Very different. From there, we're going to have a competition yellow. But to really make it exciting, we're going to have a joker lap. But you can't take that joker lap until you've had the competition yellow. After that, then you can strategize as when's the best time to take that joker lap. So here, we're heading down to turn one. That's where we had all the chaos in race one in the hairpin. Going back straightaway, that's the tire chicane where we saw a lot of tricycling lifting the wheels. Here, as we come back towards the fan-friendly area where they can see all the jumps. Now, this is where it's really interesting. There's the joker lap. So you go past our finish. There'll be cones designated that you have to get to the right side of the front straightaway. And then that shortens the track by about 12 seconds, give or take, is what that joker gets you.
And that's where the strategy comes in. This is how they'll line up. Charles Dorrance on the pole. Alongside of him, Bruce Canepa. Bruce, new to the series, but not to racing. A sports car racer from a ways back. He certainly has experience in race cars. What about trucks?
Inside row three, Nick Vanis with a lot of jet ski background along Scotty Steele. And we know Scotty just keeps getting better with every race.
Dave Royce and Keegan Kincaid fill out row three. Then back to row four, Abdali Lopez and Sheldon Creed.
And from there, Bert Jenner, Robbie Gordon with EJ Vizo, who's starting at the back and he's been coming on strong.
And you see the onboard with Vizo and Robbie Gordon. Gordon giving everybody the thumbs up, saying, hey, I'm ready to get this underway. Then to Bert Jenner. We talk about his improvement. We'll see how he runs on this new layout here.
Sheldon Creed, great to have him back. Obviously, he showed what he can do in race one here. Can he win this race and get some points and put that spread on Robbie Gordon?
Abdali Lopez was a bit of a punching bag a little bit earlier in race number one. He wants to make amends. And then Keegan Kincaid, he too has been very strong at the Super Sports Show. Then Dave Royce.
Filling in for Aaron Baumbach in the discount tire car.
Dave Royce excited about the future here. Scotty Steele, well, he is looking to move forward as well. And to do it, he'll be coming from row number two. Nick Vanis inside row two, and then to the front row, the guys that'll have the best shot out in front. There's Bruce Canepa. You ride on board with him, and he's got to be excited about what he's got in front of him and a little worried about what's behind. And then Charles Dorrance up front.
And remember, as we're about to take the green flag here, looking off to the left there, right on the wall, that's where we're going to see that green flag. Remember what we saw in race one. It was chaos because it was a big hairpin. Now it's more of a 90-degree corner.
And it's a longer run down to turn one than it was before. Green flag waves. We're racing. Two of the lesser experienced drivers up front. Let's see how long it takes before they are swallowed up by the competition down in turn one.
Well, for Bruce Canepa, this is his very first outing here. So here, he's got that whole field behind him as he's going to the brake pedal right now in turn one. And he's got the lead in that yellow truck.
You got to give it to Bruce. Way out. Naval Air Station North Island in San Diego, California is known as the birthplace of naval aviation. And for the last 16 years, the base has played host to the Coronado Speed Festival as a part of San Diego's Fleet Week. But for the first time this year, fans will witness landings on the runways like never before as Speed Energy Formula Off-Road joins the festivities. 16-year-old off-road phenom Sheldon Creed, IndyCar star EJ Vizo, and the rest of the Formula Off-Road pilots are about to launch in California. Welcome to San Diego, California, and Speed Energy Formula Off-Road presented by Traxxas. I'm Brian Till, along with former IndyCar driver Robbie Buell. Taylor Snyder down in the pit lane. What a race we have on store for you here from San Diego. One of the neat things about the Formula Off-Road Championship, such a diversity in the racetrack, Robbie.
and it is absolute diversity. Think about where we were just last night at the SandSports Super Show, and now we're here at these active military runways, totally different surface. We're all concrete pavement, very abrasive versus metal jumps, dirt jumps, and tight, twisty stuff. Incredibly different.
I think as a driver, you've got to change your approach as to how you're going to get the weekend done. You still want to win, but a little different approach. You talk about the SandSports Super Show. Well, here we are in Costa Mesa, California, Orange County Fairgrounds. An echelon-style start, lined up side-by-side like motocross racers. BJ Baldwin, Baja 1000 winner, getting introduced to that short track racing that is Formula Off-Road.
And there's the diversity. Here are your dirt jumps along the front straightaway. Great for the fans. A little bit of bumping there with EJ Vizo. We saw a lot of that, didn't we?
It wouldn't be the first time we saw EJ Vizo getting a little aggressive throughout the night. Here he is beginning to put a move on Keegan Kincaid in the number 74. But in the end of race number one of two, Robbie Gordon, who takes the victory. Keegan Kincaid finishes second. Gordon with a little bicycle. For race number two, a sellout crowd witnesses more great SST Traxxas action. Down into turn one, and then it gets a little crazy. PJ Jones, Abdali Lopez.
Drives right over his hood, and look at this battle. EJ Vizo just poking at Kincaid a little bit there. And there, that's the cutoff. PJ Baldwin taking the Joker.
Robbie Gordon was out front, but the Joker played havoc. Charles Dorrance, EJ Vizo get together. No yield sign there, and then a mechanical issue, rare mechanical issue for Robbie Gordon while leading.
Little hiccup. Hiccup gives Kincaid the lead.
Once you give a guy like Keegan Kincaid the lead, he's going to hold on to it. That's exactly what he did. He won round number two. Two great races from just down the street in Costa Mesa, but we talk about how different this racetrack is, Robbie Buell. It's on a naval airport.
And that's one of the strengths of this series, is just the diversity of the tracks. Flat concrete, 90-degree corners, turn two, very quick corner. We have this long straightaway up to speeds of 130 miles an hour, have a tire chicane there at the end, some sweeping corners. Now we're going to be setting ourselves up for some jumps, which is right where all the fans are. Want to talk about a fan-friendly racetrack? They can see everything that develops out on this active military airstrip.
And I would say that there's nothing for the drivers to hit except for the fact that there are a lot of trucks out there. They tend to rub on each other. Nick Vanis will start from the pole alongside Charles Dorrance. He didn't have the race that he wanted to have in Costa Mesa. We'll see what he can come away with here.
Row two, Scotty Steele ended up on the podium up the street last night along Lopez, who just keeps getting better and better.
Row three, EJ Vizo, so aggressive over the last two races. And Bert Jenner had a fantastic run only to cut a tire down at Costa Mesa.
And here we got Sheldon Creed back, the guy who's chasing Robbie Gordon in this championship. Let's see what he can do alongside Keegan Kincaid, who drove for him the last two events of last night.
Dave Royce, Robbie Gordon in row five. Gordon, your championship leader as you go through the onboards. Dave Royce, a very good sports car driver. His first love really was off-road trucks, so he's right where he wants to be. Sheldon Creed in the 74. Keegan Kincaid filled in for him and won points for him over the last two rounds. Now Kincaid in his own truck getting his own points.
Yeah, so we'll see if these Traxxas teammates kind of work together or not.
Talked about Bert Jenner. Man, he's come a long way as a race car driver, not just a pretty face on the Kardashians. EJ Vizo, the IndyCar star, adapting well to these trucks.
Abdali Lopez, he's having a great year with two wins at Indy and the X Games. And Scotty Steele finishing third on the podium at SandSports Super Show last night.
The guys are going to have the best shot here at the drop of the green. Charles Dorrance starts outside the front row, and Nick Vanis will start from the pole in his Icon Wraps SST Traxxas truck. Right now, fans filling the grandstands here, waiting for the flagman who's up on the wall to our screen right, waiting for the green flag. This is when you're sitting there nervous, the flag waves, and here we go, Robbie.
And hitting the ramps. And now remember, when they go down to turn one, these guys have not really had any practice time around here, and this track is wide open, and you're shooting for that cone that designates turn one.
Wide open to a hairpin, and that's one of the most challenging corners, especially when you've got a stack up. And look, here we go.
And look at all the lines. Look at these guys just running the high side all around here, stack up. We see Robbie just kind of slow right around that cone.
Scotty Steele in his bright red number five SST Traxxas truck jumps out to the lead big time after the stack up. Look at it. pushing and shoving. Abdali Lopez in the green, white, and red involved.
Vanison's involved over there. Here we're on board with Scotty Steele.
Gordon tries to go down to the inside in his Speed Energy truck.
Literally has to park the car as they all get stacked up there.
One more look at it.
Big lock up from Abdali Lopez. He gets sideways. He bumps the back of Scotty Steele, but Scotty Steele gets a great shot and takes the lead coming off of there.
On board with Abdali Lopez, he gets into the side of several of the vehicles, including Sheldon Creed. I think Keegan Kincaid is going, come on, guys, give me a break. But for Scotty Steele, from third to first at the start, can the youngster hang on and win his first Formula Off-Road event? Speed Energy Formula Off-Road is brought to you by Traxxas, the fastest name in radio control. And by Toyo Tires, driven to perform. Race one from the Coronado Speed Festival, Formula Off-Road, presented by Traxxas, underway. The youngster, Scotty Steele, 16 years old, up front and leading this field right now.
And this is a great shot. Look at the difference of where we were last night. Now, we're on this concrete pavement, big speed. Look at the movement of the trucks under braking. This is that back straightaway, about 130 miles as it approaching these tires. And look at this tricycle coming off there, just nailing the gas and ride it out and have the confidence that I can give it the throttle, it's gonna come back down.
E.J. Bezo beginning to close the distance, and you would expect E.J. Bezo, the former IndyCar driver, actually still a current IndyCar driver when he gets an opportunity, putting the pressure on him. That means he knows road course racing better than Scotty Steele. Steele comes from dirt. He's a dirt track racer, and on top of that, he's 16 years old. He doesn't have nearly the experience that E.J. Bezo has. Doing a good job to hold his own, but you'd think Bezo would have the upper hand.
You would think, but Scotty, that's been his program all year, is he's racing everything he can, just bringing that learning curve along. And, you know, E.J.'s going to be there pressuring him. E.J.'s got a little white hood on that from last night.
DOT-approved Toyo tires, and oh, contact down in turn one. Robbie Gordon is a part of it.
Lopez is. Kincaid is. Look at that. Look at the big speed. Robbie just coming in there, locks it up, and uses Abdali, I think, really as the brake once he gets in there.
Oh, yeah, I think Robbie would even tell you he just got in there way, way too quickly. Locks the rear end. On board with Abdali Lopez. He thinks everything's fine.
He's rolling into the corner now. Where's the impact? There it is.
Where did that come from? Rare mistake by Robbie Gordon. Gets a little loose, and Gordon drops well back in the order, almost to the back. And how much damage does he have? A little bit of body work. That's not at all uncommon in this series. That won't slow him down, but does he have any suspension damage after that hard contact?
Well, keep in mind, right now, these guys are really in this race now, learning this racetrack. They've had very little time here. You know, the team has done a great job. Look, we got a battle for the lead. EJ looking down the inside. It's not gonna happen. Scotty, great job.
EJ Bezo shifting gears, the lever on the left, the gear shift, the lever on the right, a turning brake, locks the rear end.
And there he's got it.
Done. Gets it done. E.J. Bezo goes to the lead.
But a great opportunity. Now, Scotty needs to latch onto his rear bumper and just follow him, figure out where he's a little bit quicker, where he's a little bit slower, and just kind of refine his line as they're learning around this racetrack. Like I say, they just got here this morning, so these guys, fantastic air shot there. How about that? That's just in
talk
the trunk
about,
of that truck.
Man, talk about landing here at the Naval Air Station. You just saw it. I think perhaps a little bit of setup differences on the truck. Here's the pass for the lead, E.J. Bezo. Just gets a better shot, goes around the outside.
Yeah, just kind of rolled that speed on the outside, for sure.
Robbie Gordon trying to work his way back. A little bit of smoke from the left rear of Robbie Gordon's Speed Energy SST Traxxas truck.
And as these drivers are approaching this turn one again, they're trying to get some references of where is the good braking point. How can they deep can they get in under the brake pedal?
Well, I go back to these are DOT approved Toyo tires. They're the same tires that you would buy at the tire store down the way, and they are taking punishment here on these concrete runways and taxiways. On board with Abdali Lopez.
And look at that, a little bit of bumping with Burt Jenner in the Gladiator tire truck.
Jenner, we talked about him at the beginning, doing such a great job improving every weekend. And he had a great run at the Sand Sports Super Show. Just cut down a tire in race number two there. And that cost him, but improving every weekend for EJ Vizo. He's been spectacular, especially on the street type circuit.
No, and that's his home, so you'd expect him to be good at that. But where he's really good is just adapting to these trucks and just the different style of that. And I think it's an aggressive style. It's not as much, so much about road racing if you come from sports car racing of being precise. You got to be a little wider and wide open, and EJ brings that. You never know what he's going to do from one turn to the next in terms of his aggressiveness and just driving it in there hard.
Well, and I think there is a different setup on the trucks for Scotty Steele and EJ Vizo. You see Scotty Steele really pick up the inside front tire a lot. EJ Vizo's truck much flatter across the front. The front, right front or inside front will come off the ground. Oh, that is tight.
And he looks over at him right there, and Scotty, and he got that position. Creed, that was Sheldon Creed, got that position on Scotty Steele. But you make a good point, is we see Scotty really lifting that inside tire, and that just could be a softer rear end, a softer bar. A little damage there on Abdali Lopez Visit Mexico car.
On board with Dave Royce, his very first ever Formula off-road race. This is a guy who used to work on Group 7 trucks back when the Mickey Thompson series was running. He said that's what he really wanted to do, but it was too expensive to get into, so he went sports car racing. Well, guess what? Now Robbie Gordon and the Speed Energy Formula Off-Road Series presented by Traxxas is a much more affordable way to go racing. Dave Roy says, this is where I want to be. He's planning on running a full season next year.
And it worked out pretty well. He is actually subbing for Aaron Baumbach that hurt himself just going off of one of the jumps and just landed funny, just tweaked his back a little bit at the Sandsport event. So great that Dave can fill in, because this is where he wants to be all next year.
Yeah, he was out here to watch anyway, so he's taking over the discount tire truck. And Aaron's injury actually was a re-injury from a sports car crash. So there you have it. Right now, though, out in front, EJ Vizo, Robbie Gordon trying to charge forward. Next on his list, it's going to be Keegan Kincaid trying to make up the positions lost there with that spin down to turn one.
And you have to love the double ramps right along start finish. You got all the fans running up to the fence. They got their phones just videoing the jumps, and these guys are hitting those speeds, and they're launching up to close to 200 feet long coming off these ramps.
Absolutely spectacular racing. The white flag is out for EJ Vizo. Just about a half a lap to go in the back part of the course right now. Half a lap, but another five corners and three jumps the way I see it, Robbie.
Yeah, and he's got nobody breathing on him, so he just got to bring this home, think about what he's got to do for the next race.
Well, you want to make sure that you save your truck. You know you've got race number two coming up, and you want to make sure you save the tires, those Toyo tires. Punished right now. Amazing they hold up like they do. But for EJ Vizo, looking for another victory in the Formula Off-Road Series presented by Traxxas.
There he is. Now there, he's making the right-hander coming onto the front race. We've got double jump, and he's going to be coming right to the checkered. We're on board with EJ right there.
And a great shot of the crowds in the grandstand. And you can see just how high they jump. And look at this. It is not over until it's over.
Lopez.